This video is sponsored by sellcashier.com. They compare iPhone prices on the internet and give you their instant quote and the most cash for your iPhone.
Hey guys, this is Evo Tecarium. It's finally getting colder here in Washington DC, and this season brought us some great techs, and iPhone X is one of them. But is it really worth your money? Let's suppose you have an iPhone 7 Plus just like this one on the left. Is it really worth your money upgrading to a 10? In this benchmark comparison video, I will try to answer this question for you. We are going to start our quest with the Geekbench 4. Alright guys, so the results are up, and of course, as expected, iPhone 10 would definitely outperform the 7 Plus to your left and the iPhone 10 on the right. The point here is that even though these numbers are vastly different, especially the multi-core score on the 10 is 2 times higher than the multi-core score on the iPhone 7 Plus, remember that in the daily life, you won't really notice that difference. Look at the fluidity of the interface. There's virtually no delay, there's no lag, and it works very smooth on both of these devices. So the iOS, the way that it performs on both of these phones, you won't really notice a difference. So one of the other tests I want to run is also the performance test mobile, and then we're going to go back to the Geekbench, and going to do is we're going to run the second test. It's called the compute, and we're going to see how they perform side by side next to each other. Alright guys, so the results are up, and this is performance test mobile. iPhone 10 outperforms the 7 Plus by a factor of 2 in a lot of these tests, and just like the Geekbench 4, this is to once again prove a point that even though this is a much more powerful handset, it's really hard to tell with a naked eye the performance difference. So when you saw some of the visual tests, you know, you couldn't really tell the difference because neither one of these phones were lagging. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to look at the weather.com. The Weather Channel website is extremely information rich, and sometimes it will take a minute to load on some of the devices, but definitely not these two. But let's see if there's any visual difference and how long it's going to pull up the website. So iPhone 10 is actually a fraction of a second faster. Again, you still see everything on the 7 Plus almost immediately. So like I said, you know, there's really very little difference when it comes to opening the websites. And so also here is YouTube, and we're going to pull up a video and see how long it takes to cache and open it up on each one of these handsets. And I bet that they will essentially be the same. So iPhone 10 is slightly faster, as was expected from looking at the weather.com, and this is pretty much the to sort of relay the idea of this being a little bit more powerful. This test is also dependent on Wi-Fi, of course, and I don't believe that I'm getting the best service here by Comcast, but that's a completely different story. But just to prove a point, this is a little bit faster, but it's a very, very, very negligible difference. The next thing I want to talk about is I want to go away from the internals of these devices and just kind of look at and compare what they look like on the outside. First of all, this comes with the face recognition. So what you're seeing right now, this little lock, it's recognizing my face right now and it's unlocking the phone. So I think this is a really great feature. Works 99% of the time, does not work consistently well. These unfortunately, of course, don't come with it. But this is the newest feature on this. But also remember, there's no button on this, and the screen is essentially huge. I mean, the bezels are very small and the size is smaller. I'm trying to get you to understand that this is a lot more expensive and it's probably not worth your money. However, what I can also tell you is that I absolutely love this phone. So if I ever used an Apple iPhone as a daily driver for myself, I would probably go with it then just because of the smaller size. It's marginally larger than an 8 or a 7, but certainly smaller than a Plus. So size-wise, this is a perfect solution for me, and just the fact that there's no button. But if you're really used to this button here, if you really don't want to spend a lot of money, you should probably still stick with the 7 Plus, just because the performance difference between these two is really not going to be any different. If you look at the maps, there's virtually no delay. They work extremely fast side by side, just like that. And you can magnify, and it works amazingly well. One of the other things that I also want to bring to your attention, this is the OLED screen. This is higher clarity, of course, it contributes to a higher price of this device, because I really think that this is definitely a flagship, but this is what you're getting for the money. It's a similar price. If you don't currently have an iPhone, it's probably possible to consider getting this, but again, you will be investing into a phone case and probably insurance, because this is glass all around. So you drop it once, it'll probably break the entire phone. So we're going back to Geekbench right now, and what we're going to do is we're going to run the second test, which is called the compute, and we're going to see how they perform side by side next to each other. All right, guys, so the results are up from Geekbench 4. This is the compute test, and interestingly enough, with the mathematical operations, these phones stand really, really close next to each other. Look at the actual score. So this test for the processor and the computation power of the processor's architecture, and we're looking at some fairly large differences here between the two, essentially two generations apart. But look at the score. This is very, very similar. And so that's another reason that you should probably not waste your money on a 10 and stick with the 7 Plus. And the reason I pulled up the weather app is to show you the difference in the screen clarities and the screen resolution. When I first looked at the 7 Plus about a year and a half ago, I looked at it and I was like, wow, that's an amazing screen. It looks great and the picture is completely clear. Well, now I'm looking at the 10 and the quality of the picture is even better than the 7 Plus. Again, that's something that brings on, you know, increases the price of the iPhone 10 compared to a 7 Plus, of course. I would say that you probably should not. This is over $1,000, and to be honest with you, this is actually the expensive version. This is a 256 gigabyte version, which was well over $1,200. All right, guys, so why am I telling you all this? Why am I showing you all this? This is really to prove a point that for using these phones every single day, for writing emails, sending text messages, making phone calls, browsing the web a little bit, there's really no difference. The operating system is exactly identical, except that you, of course, can use gestures on this phone. There's no button, and it's smaller in size. On the other hand, you have the 7 Plus that costs less money. You already have it. Should you upgrade to a 10? I say not. Don't spend, you know, over $1,000 on that. This is actually $1,250 with tax, because this is the more expensive 256 gigabyte version. So stick with the 7 Plus. Just keep this phone. It's great. It will serve you for a long time, and the 10 is definitely not worth your money. As always, thank you for watching. I hope this is helpful, and I will see you in my next video very soon.
I wanted to tell you about sellcashier.com. So you just got your new iPhone. What will you do with your old one? You may be thinking of selling it on eBay, Craigslist, and so on, and it is definitely a hassle. Now you don't have to do that. Now you can sell it through sellcashier.com. They compare the actual prices of iPhones and give you the best price for your iPhone that you are trying to sell. And the good thing is that you are guaranteed the best rate. You also get a free shipping label. Thank you for watching, and please check out sellcashier.com.